Hello, welcome learners to another interesting session of Advertising Models. I'm Dr. Mo Mukherjee Das, Media Faculty, Future Media School, Maulana Abdul Kalam University of Technology, Kolkata, West Bengal. Learners, we have studied earlier in the earlier session about advertising theories. Now, what is advertising? What is advertising? We have studied it's a non-personal communication, paid form by an identified sponsor and for a specific target market, about products, ideas and services, persuasive in nature, and it through various mediums it has been targeted. While studying about advertising models, we need to know what is a model. So what is a model? An advertising model is the strategic use of an advertising medium with the goal of reaching a specific target audience. What is an advertising medium? Advertising mediums are the different mediums through which ads are targeted to us target people. What are the different advertising mediums? For example, advertising mediums are television, radio, print media, social media, folk media, out-of-home advertisements like those in the billboards, posters, and even those advertisements which are we happen to see in the vehicles, transit mediums. So there are different mediums of advertising. Advertising model tells us how we should design a message so that it reaches effectively to the specified target audiences. It provides a strategic instructions guide to the advertisers to understand the communication process, how it should be targeted to reach the target people. An advertising medium is the type of media or vehicle the advertising is placed on. Therefore, understanding the target market helps to create an effective message and therefore helps to determine the appropriate advertising medium. To start with the advertising models, we will come to the first model called AIDA model. You see this model. This model, the AIDA model, the full form of which stands for attention, interest, desire, and action. This is a behavioral model created by Strong in 1925. And the main purpose was to create high awareness, stimulate interest, and leading the consumer towards desired action. It proposes five cognitive stages: attention, interest, desire, action, and retention. Now, what is attention? For example, attention is if you are being drawn towards that particular advertisement. Attention means creating brand awareness among the target by calling for attention. How will you create awareness about a product if the people are not viewing that particular ad, if the people had not seen that ad? Therefore, first and foremost strategy is to make people draw their attention towards that particular advertisement. Next is interest. Interest is generating interest among the common target, among the target market, so that they are encouraged to buy. If there is no interest in the product, people will not buy that product. So you see, there are challenges in every step. If people are not attracted towards that advertisement, if people are not aware about the advertisements, obviously they will not have any interest. If they have developed an attention, they will definitely go for interest. If they develop some kind of interest in the ad, only they will go for the next step, that is called desire. What is desire? It's forming an emotional connect with the buyers and thus creating a desire for the product. If you don't have an emotional connect with the buyer, then it will be impossible for the buyer to purchase that product. So it is impossible for the advertisement to create an emotional connect so that the consumers are able to relate to that ad and buy that product ultimately. Finally, it is called call for action, the ultimate purchase of the product. Now, I might be drawn towards that particular ad. I might be interested in that particular ad. I might even have the desire for the product, but I might not have the money to buy that product. So ultimately, there is another challenge. I might not have the need to buy that product. So there is another challenge. Therefore, overcoming this challenge, I will go for the next step, that is called action, and will finally purchase the product. When all other factors like having money or having the need, or only then my problem will be solved. When all these factors are resolved, the next step, action, will be taken and I will buy that product. After buying that product, it is very important for the advertiser to keep a tab or connect with the consumer even after purchase, or otherwise the consumer might feel a bit of isolated. So retention is very important. How the advertisers will keep the consumer thread alive? By bonding with them so that they spread positive reviews, word of mouth, and act as referrals, and so on. If I'm happy with the product, I will definitely go for positive reviews. And if I am not so happy, I will just stop providing referrals to other persons. So the main issue of AIDEA is there are challenges at every step. And if one step one misses, the next step will not be fulfilled. If you miss out on the awareness about a product, you will not call for attention. If the advertiser fails to draw your attention as a consumer, your attention is not drawn towards that ad, you will miss out that ad. And obviously there will be a failure in your interest. If you develop an interest, but you don't have the need, you will have no desire to buy that product. You have an interest, but you don't have the money to buy the product, you will not go for desire. Even if you have a desire, even if you develop a desire, again, the same problem will come. I might need a BMW. I might have a desire to buy a BMW, but then I don't need particularly this car right now. So my desire does not translate into action. So when my desire gets translated into action, only then the advertising is effective in helping the consumer to take an informed decision. And finally, after buying that product, retention of the consumer is also very important, where the consumer will happily refer this product to other people as well. Next model, the Dagmar model. Now, the Dagmar is an acronym of which the full form is defining advertising goals for measured advertising results. It was devised by Russell H. Cole for the Association of National Advertisers. What it does, it helps in identifying the objectives and focuses to measure the results of an advertising campaign. Now, when you are designing an advertising message, you should know what your objective is, why you are giving this advertising. If you are not clear of your objective, you will not be able to measure your objective effectively, whether your advertisement will be effective in return, whether people will go for the product or not. So it helps in identifying the objectives. It will help in guiding you to locate what are your objectives. A Dagmar approach moves through awareness, comprehension, conviction, and action. Awareness about the existence of the product in the market. If you don't know that the product exists in the market, obviously you will not be, not go to buy that product. Comprehension, a good understanding of the product should be made available to the consumer by the advertiser, so that they can make informed decision. In this case, you should be aware about what are the features, about what are the benefits that a product is going to offer. And that is the responsibility of the advertiser. Advertisers should not hide anything from a consumer. So comprehension is very important to take an informed decision by the consumer. Conviction, where the customer is convinced and gets ready to buy the product. I am convinced as a customer, I am ready to buy the product. Therefore, as a consumer, I am attracted towards the particular product. I can fully comprehend what are the benefits and features it is going to provide me as a consumer. And finally, I'm convinced that if I buy this product, I will be benefited in the long run. Finally, if I am convinced, I will go for action. I will finally purchase that product. A major contribution of Kohler's Dagmar approach was a specifying what constitutes a good objective that can reach effectively the target consumer and can convert the investment of the company into return on investment. Dagmar approaches thus helps the advertisers to effectively design what should be the objective and how it should be measured, and to see that what should be the return on investment if they design the message in a particular manner. According to Russell H. Kohler, there are various advantages of a well-founded objective. These are: it should be concrete, measurable. The objectives of communication should be brief and precise and should be written in clear language. It should not have any technical jargons, technical words that can make it more confusing. It should be measurable. Have a well-defined target audience or market. The target market should be well-defined and very clear. The advertisers must know whom to approach and how, where, and when. This can be possible only through the demographic, psychographic, and geographic segmentation. What is this segmentation? Whether the ad is going local, regional, national, international. This is the geographic segmentation. What is the lifestyle? What is the gender? What is the preferences of the consumer? These when are studied properly and researched properly. Only then you can find out who exactly is your target audience. A clearly defined target market enables the advertiser to design the message clearly. Identify the benchmark and degree of change needed to bring about. This is very essential for an appropriate measurement of the effectiveness of the advertisement. Specify a time frame to accomplish the objective. Should have defined time frame, as that enables the advertiser to set goals and design message accordingly. The time frame should be realistic to prohibit erroneous and skewed results. Suppose you launch a particular product in the market through a particular advertisement. You will have to define a time frame. It cannot, an advertisement message cannot go on forever and ever. It should be within a specific time period, within 6 months, within 1 year. The advertiser should see whether it is achieving the desired results. Only then it will be successful. It is very important to measure the objective clearly so that to define the target market and thereby specify a time frame in to observe the realistic results and to prohibit any erroneous and skewed results. Next is the Ehrenberg model. In Ehrenberg model that was designed in the 1997, there is awareness, trial, reinforcement, and nudging. What is awareness? We have already studied. Awareness is the existence of a product in the market. Whether you, if you are not aware about the existence of a particular product in the market, you will never go to buy that product. So Andrew Ehrenberg devised this weak theory, and it has this following components. The awareness serves to let a consumer know of your existence. Trial, it inspires the customer's interest. If you are not aware about the product's availability in the market, then you will not come to know about the product. It is quite natural. And after you know about that product, there should be a trial, because trial inspires the customer's interest. I think you all are aware that there is a test drive for cars or bikes. We often observe also that there are small sample pouch attached with the advertisements or as a free gift to with another product. This is because it induces the trial interest in us so that we are induced to use that product, and thereby we create an interest. Finally, reinforcement. If you are convinced about that product after using that trial, you will go for buying that product because it builds your trust. It creates a loyalty bond with you, and finally you purchase that product. Final step is that of nudging. It closes the sale. Once you buy that product, your ultimate desire to purchase that product is over, and the ultimate aim of selling the product of the advertiser is also over. The DRIP model. The DRIP model is another acronym for differentiate. D for differentiate. R for remind, I for inform, and P for persuade. Differentiate. For example, I will start this with an example of a soap. If I keep all the soaps that are available in the market in front of you, and their brand names removed, their covers removed, the brand names that are embedded in the soap, they are removed, will you be able to identify the soaps? It is impossible. You will be able to identify maybe by their fragrance, by their shape, by their color, but I can assure you there are numerous soaps that have same fragrance, that have same color, same shape, same packaging and everything. So what is different? Different is the brand name. Different is how do you differentiate one product from the other? When you package that soap with a particular, wrapper, the packaging tells all the difference. The quality, the features available in the soap tells all the difference. You can then distinguish that this soap is this brand, this soap is that brand. Otherwise, it is impossible for you to differentiate. Remind, once you differentiate from one product from the other, then we go for reminding. That it is important for us to remind again and again to the consumer that this is our brand, these are our features, please buy this product. This is very important. And finally, we will communicate, inform, and educate about products offering to the prospects. This can include new features, benefits, availability, offers, value, etc. And persuade. Persuading the target audience to behave in a particular way so that it evokes a certain attitude within customers. To persuade, there is a need to emotionally connect with the consumer through social media websites, free trials, exchange offers, etc. So DRIP model, in a way, persuades us step by step to purchase the product. You see this product, how this advertisement is targeting through this product, Colgate ad. It is distinguishing how does your toothpaste have salt. So if there is salt, toothpaste, Colgate is the ultimate. Salt feature is the benefit that it is providing, and salt is distinguishing it from other brands also. Next is Pepsodent. What is Pepsodent saying? It is 130% germ attack power. So when you buy a Pepsodent toothpaste, you are sure that it has features that will protect your tooth by 130% germ attack. These are some of the features which is induced in you and through the advertisement, and is trying to create an awareness about the product, and is trying to persuade you that to buy this particular product. Next is the Lavage and Steiner model. The Lavage and Steiner model is about unawareness, moving to awareness, to knowledge, to liking, to preference, and to conviction. What is it? This model created is known as the hierarchy of effects model in 1961, where they proposed 6 stages through which an advertiser encourages a consumer to travel from product advertisement to product purchase. Awareness, making consumers aware about the product, its features, price, availability, and other benefits in the market. Knowledge, The customer starts gaining information about the product and its features through various sources like the websites, retail advisors, word of mouth, and product packaging. Liking. This step ensures that the customer likes the product. Preference. When the consumer places more importance on one product over another, then it is the winning edge for the advertisers. To achieve this, the advertiser have to highlight the various benefits and features and unique selling proposition that a product has to offer. Conviction. In this stage, the consumer decides to buy the product. The advertiser simply needs to encourage the consumer by helping him to take a decision and finally purchase. That is, after having developed a positive belief system about the product, the consumer now have to make the purchase. Next is the Laswell's model of communication. Laswell's model, given by Harold Dwight Laswell, he was an American political scientist, and he found a simple and convenient way to describe an act of communication by answering certain questions. Who says what, in which channel, to whom, and with what effect? When I try to put it in terms of advertising, it says in this model, the communication component, who refers the research area called the control analysis, says what is refers to content analysis, in which channel is refers to media analysis, to whom is refers to audience analysis, and with what effect is refers to effect analysis. You see this advertisement now. An advertisement by Naukri.com says who says what, to whom, and with what effect, in what channel, and what it is trying to say. All the elements of communication have been addressed. In this ad posted by Naukri.com, you will see the certain elements that has been stressed of this communication model. The communication component, that what is being told about the ad, in which channel, who is saying, whom it is saying, and with what effect it is being said. So when I observe this ad, I immediately come to know what the advertisers want to say through this ad. Maslow's model of hierarchy of needs. Maslow's model gives us five segments, five main components. What are they? The most basic needs are physiological needs, food, clothing, and shelter. These are the underlying needs without which humans can't live. Safety needs. Human beings are constantly under fear. Therefore, they stress the importance of safety, whether physically, financially, or job security and health. Social needs, family bonding, and social connections are the things every human beings value. Esteem needs, desire to be respected, desire for respect by others, includes self-esteem, confidence, and a sense of self-achievement is one of the primary concerns. And finally, self-actualization. This is realizing one's full potential. Whenever an ad is targeted to the target market, the advertisers keep in mind the different needs of the target market. The basic need is food, clothing, and shelter. Next is the safety needs. If I don't have a job security, if I don't have money in my pocket, I will be mentally distraught. If I don't have a family, for whom I will do the spending? If I have no have love, if I don't know what is love, if I don't know what is the family bonding, if I don't know how, if I don't have somebody to talk to at the end of the day, then my social needs are not satisfied. Therefore, I need to be satisfied. My social needs needs to be satisfied. Esteem needs. I need respect in my company, in my job, in my workplace, in my family, amongst my family members, amongst my peers. There is the esteem need. And self-actualization. So when I see the ads targeting these needs, obviously my advertisement will be successful. We see various needs being targeted by the advertisers. We will see these ads in the next slide. You see, in the slide, in the advertisement by Coca-Cola, what it says, happiness, Coca-Cola. So at the end of the day, we have somebody to share our joys, feelings, sorrows, emotions, and happiness lies in over there. There is the belonging need. Next is the safety need. What is it being said that if you don't wear a helmet, you might meet the hell over there? So ultimately, it is stressing on our safety needs, because if you are careful about your safety, you will never miss your helmet. That is how Maslow's hierarchy of needs target the consumers. Next model is the product life cycle model, PLC. If you see this model, you will see it's a graph. And in the plotting of the graph, it is introduction, growth, maturity, decline. Now, what is this graph? Every human being we know goes through a life cycle. We are born first, then we become small children, then teenagers, then matured adults, then midlife comes, and finally we die. Similarly, a product too goes through its life cycle. A product is first introduced into the market. People get accustomed to that market. It grows in demand, in sales. It reaches its maturity level. And finally, it declines. So a product has four stages of its entire life cycle: introduction, growth, maturity, and decline. Advertising campaigns, design strategies, and expenditures differ in each stage. Each stage has its own set of guidelines for advertising. An advertiser has to look carefully what his design should be, as target market varies according to the stage cycle. So if you see, a product when initially launched has to be, the advertiser has to spend extensively on it. In the growth level also, the advertiser has to spend extensively on it. In maturity level, the advertiser might low down its estimate, might low down its budget. And decline is the conscious decision of the advertiser to close the product because of various factors. You see in my next slide, we are aware about these products: floppy disk, tape recorder, Walkman. These products were quite popular in yesteryears. But with gradual upgrading of technology, they have met their fate. Their popularity have declined. And finally, they have died a gradual death. So product life cycle, they were hugely popular. They had had their maturity level. And finally, they had died. Again, this is a high definition television which we are seeing. This high definition television is in vogue right now. It is hugely popular among the common people. We never know what holds for us in future. In the future, this high definition television may be obsolete because of the technology, and some other new technology may come in, whereby we will see this high definition technology will be declining in sales, in popularity. So the product life cycle varies accordingly in each stages, and the advertisers should design their advertising messages according to the product life cycle. Now, next model is the VIPS model. The VIPS model was given by David Bernstein, and it stands for visibility, identity, promise, single-mindedness. What is visibility? Visibility relates to the exposure rate. That is, how many people had seen the ad, the creative appeal that it has made, that makes it easily noticeable. People should talk about the advertisement. Identity. The consumer is busy, therefore, the brand should clearly be identified in the ad, and the consumer only glances at it. We all know that consumer is so busy, that that he or she has hardly any time to see the ad in a detailed manner. Therefore, the ad should be very, it should be identified by the brand, and the consumer only glances at it and catches a glimpse of the ad. The logo, the slogan should be clearly understood. Promise, the brand benefits and unique features should be highlighted. The positioning and the message should be clear. Unique selling proposition as well as the offer needs to be clearly conveyed to the customer. Fevicol has been successful in its attempt to showcase it as the ultimate adhesive. The ad should deliver on its promise. Single-mindedness. Too much elements in a message clutters the whole objective. You know, when there are too much elements in an advertising message, we tend to confuse. The consumers confuse that what the ads want to say. Therefore, the consumer should not get confused. It should give only one message. The focus should be only one message told in a consistent manner. Tata. The Tata catch line says, we also make steel. Sale catch line, Steel Authority of India Limited catch line says, there is a little bit of sell in everybody's life. The message is consistent. The Tata logo is consistent. The Tata image is consistent in every advertisement that we see. See this ad, the Fevicol ad. In the Fevicol ad, the Fevicol catch line, the ultimate adhesive, is consistent. The Fevicol logo with two elephants is consistent anywhere we go. And the Fevicol has a high exposure rate. So whenever we are observing an ad, we can see that that particular ad should have high visibility, should be consistent in a message, in the message that it is delivering, and should be able to deliver on the promise that it is saying. It should be able to deliver its features, its unique elements, whatever it is promising to the consumer, therefore making itself a very renowned brand. So dear learners, hope you have understood advertising models and have cleared all the concepts that regarding cleared all the concepts about advertising models. Have a good day. Thank you very much. Thank you.